But like I said, I already made one mistake, and I made one extra cell. So one of these cells is going to have a line through it, but it's going to all be the same color. But that's not a big deal. We'll just carry on with it. Because again, this is about practice. So I'm going to start off with the yellow. And what we're the idea behind this is that we want to, in this yellow cell, we want to have those different variations of that practice scale that I have up on the front of the board here. So we want to make sure that in each one of these areas, so in each area of this yellow, I want to have different variations of that hue, of that color. So I want to have my 7 through 1, and sometimes it might be a blur, it might not be that many different choices, but I want to see that you're creating those different values with each color. That's where the big practice comes in on this project, okay? Is that we are taking, not just putting, filling, now that I've drawn it in, not just putting yellow over it, but that we're practicing, and maybe even like, I might see in this little area where it's an area of a gradient where I went from a dark yellow to letting it fade out. Or maybe somewhere inside of it, I did a little bit of wet and wet inside of one of the horns to give it some texture, okay? So that's where we're trying to practice some of these techniques. Maybe one area is just going to be flat. Remember, in the center, it's going to all come down to where it's going to be gray in the middle. Okay, so I'm going to start off today with the yellow. So see how I broke it down to kind of imitate this color wheel? I broke it down into the different areas. I did just put a little Y for my primary colors, a yellow, a blue, and a red marking just so I know where I'm at. Because it did get a little confusing, so that's okay to do stuff like that on this painting, okay? So let's just start off with creating a wash. One thing I never do when I'm painting, and I'm gonna try to just move this over here, is I do not like to have my supplies on my left, because I'm right-handed, because as soon as I drag it over, it never fails where I drop paint onto my project. So you always, if you're right-handed, you want your stuff to your right so that you can work without worrying about that. Make sure you have your paper towel and everything that you're going to need. Let's start off with the gradient up here. Looks like the ink I used isn't waterproof, so it's gonna run slightly in there, but that's okay. I want it to be a little darker back there, so what am I gonna add with that? Anybody? With yellow to darken it down, I'm going to add purple. I can also, if I have a like color, like this one over here, see how this yellow is darker than that yellow? So I can even try some of that first to see if that's gonna be dark enough. Paint that in, but it's not quite how dark I want it, so I'm gonna go ahead and darken it just a little bit more. That looks pretty good for now. And then over here, I'm gonna probably do that same color, but as a flat wash. See, just a little bit of paint already, and it's already starting to pop this one antler out. Oh, that's upsetting that the black's doing that. Guess I should have read my marker first, but I thought everything I had was waterproof. It's still gonna be okay.
So then do you want us to do that with like the circle and the things
coming out? Nope, you don't have to. That's just what I'm doing on this one to kind of illustrate it, because I felt like the last time that I did this, people still didn't quite understand that we're separating it into the different colors, into the 12 different colors. It can blend in nice and neat. I mean, it doesn't have to have the broken lines like that. That's just if you feel like you want to do it that way. See, by putting your little bit of pencil shading under there, it helps you with the value scale and textures by having some texture under there. This black, though, is really aggravating. I'm gonna darken that background just a hair. Remember, you really wanna try to only work on one cell at a time, because if you don't, you're gonna end up with it all running together, unless that's what you're trying to do. See, just paint in layers. Don't rush it. Don't go too dark right off the bat, because it's harder to get rid of it if it's too dark versus light. When it's too light, it's real easy to add more color.